Practice drills to develop timing and response for blocking and throwing low kicks. Make sure when you're doing bag work to visualize incoming low kicks. Block and counter them. Drills should be practiced slow enough and with very light power to assure good habits are developed. Repeat these drills back and forth, switching off with your partner. The correct way to block a low kick is to raise the knee up while remaining curled at the waist so that your hands are still up protecting your head. Your elbows remain close to the body and near the hips. The elbows should be outside of the thigh. Make sure your hands are high enough to protect your head. Reaching to catch a low kick is dangerous since a fake to the leg followed by a kick or punch to the head is common. Throwing punches with all the weight shifted on the lead leg or moving in too fast make you a prime target for a sharp low kick as demonstrated in this fight. Make sure your jabs are always sharp and effective and train by blocking over and over after you throw punches or kicks. The lead leg cross block is an effective block against a low kick to your rear leg depending on your balance and preference. With this block, the lead leg crosses the body to crush the low kick. Alternatively, the rear leg crosses the body to crush a low kick to the lead leg. Avoid eating low kick due to poor footwork. That could mean stepping forward or laterally without throwing something or backing up or because of lack of awareness. Be cautious not to walk directly into the kick as this drill demonstrates. And if you're drilling offense, be ready to strike your opponent if he steps right into it. Maintain balance on both legs so that raising your leg to block is fast and possible. If you do eat a low kick, it's important to counter right away rather than stand there, making yourself vulnerable for additional blows. These simple drills will build up your sense of timing and assure the correct response.